Hello and welcome to Charter Local Edition Northwest. I'm Dana Cowley and today we're in Olympia talking to your lawmakers and the things they're working on for you. My guest today is Senator Curtis King. Thank you so much for being here.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you for the opportunity.
Curtis represents the Central Washington area and you have worked vigorously to try to create some type of transportation package for the good of the state.
Well, that's our hope, that it is for the good of the state. We have a lot of challenges in transportation. And a lot of them we have created ourselves. We've passed gas tax increases in 03 and 05, but we didn't put any money into maintenance and preservation in either one of those packages. So we've experienced shortfalls in how we maintain our roads and highways and our bridges, and so we need to address that. We're also looking at shortfalls that we've seen over the last several years in our funding for state patrol and our funding for ferries. And so we have to address those issues and see if we can't take care of those shortfalls as well. And then we think that transportation is key to our economy.
It is.
You know, and particularly if you think about Central Washington and
all
of our fruit and agricultural products that are there, getting them to port is vital. And so we got to look at trying to finish Snoqualmie Pass and the improvements that we have been making there over the last 5 or 6 years, improving our ingress and egress out of the Port of Seattle and the Port of Tacoma. Those two by themselves are about $1.5 billion in expense. So they're not easy solutions, they're expensive solutions. But our caucus has said, well, as we look at this, we need to reform the system as well. We're not just going to give you more money and say, you know, go spend it like you have been. So we have developed reforms that have to do with permitting, both the permits before you get the project and the permits that you have to have after the project, to streamline those things so that it's you can get those permits quicker, easier, without really giving up any of the benefits that would be gained from ecology and those kinds of things. We make sure that it's fair and it's equitable across the board. So,
How are you being received by the folks on the other side of the House?
Well, we've, as I say, I've worked on this particularly with Representative Cliburn, who's the chair of transportation in the House, and she brought forth the first proposal back in the fall of 2012, if you can believe it. And we've been working on that ever since. And I would say that at the beginning of this year, Senator Hobbs and Senator Leas, who are Democrats, and Senator Fain and I sat down and said, okay, it's time that we figure out what we're doing and get this done. We can't wait much longer. And so we've worked very diligently and tried to work bipartisanly. And I think about a month ago we reached agreement on what we said was the package that we would move forward, and we now have that package voted off the Senate floor and over into the House to see what they may do with it. But it was very challenging, but very rewarding as well. But
since you've worked with this so intimately and you understand business and agriculture, if I'm a relatively large grower in southeastern Washington, what will this mean to my business and my crops?
Well, our hope is that one, you're going to have a higher quality road to bring your product to the port, as an example, or to whatever market you have, so that it's not beat up by potholes and those kinds of things. But I think more importantly, it's like completing Snoqualmie Pass, so that you know that in the winter time, that pass is not going to be closed down because of slides, things that we have experienced in the past, that you can count on your semi-truck full of apples, as an example, not only to get across the pass, but then be able to get to whichever port you want it to go to so it can get on the right ship or get on an airplane, as it would be with cherries, and do that in a manner that gives you confidence that that's what's going to happen when that truck leaves your facility.
And then for just a citizen like me, my family, what benefit would I have if this package passes?
Well, I
and
think,
then
yeah.
What would it cost me?
Yeah, well, it's going to cost you, the package puts forth an 11.7 cent increase in gas tax over 3 years. I believe it's 5 cents the first year, 4.2 the second, and 3.5 the third. And you say, well, that's a large tax increase, and it is. We haven't had one since 2008. Mm-hmm. We all know what prices have done since then. Doesn't make any difference that it's in transportation. The prices have still gone up. The other aspect to why more money is needed is that we rely heavily on that gas tax to fund our transportation system. And as cars have improved their miles per gallon, therefore they're buying less gas, therefore there's less revenue. And so we've been struggling to make sure we had enough money for maintenance, as I've said, maintenance and preservation, and then to look at new projects that need to be done because, you know, we are growing as a state.
Oh, yes.
And when we grow, it puts further burdens on our transportation system, and we have to respond to that.
So. Well, thank you. We appreciate your time and efforts on this. And thanks for your time. I know you're busy to come and visit with us.
Pleasure is mine.
And we thank you for watching. I'm Dana Cowley. This is Senator Curtis King, and you're watching Charter Local Edition Northwest in Olympia. Well, I think we got a lot of content in
there. Well, hopefully.
Did you feel good about it?
Yeah, no.